Hey, welcome to this Jira to Jira integration tutorial. Next, I am going to show you how you can integrate any Jira, either within or your organization or between different organizations. My name is Jose. I'm pre-sales engineer at Exalate. And what you see on the screen that I'm sharing is on the right, my Jira cloud demo environment, and on the left, my Jira server demo environment. And if you see closely, what I just put on the Jira server is a ticket that has the same information from the ticket on the right. If you see the title, description, and comments, they're all the same. And that is because this ticket is in sync with an Exalate connection. So that's what I'm going to show you in this video, is how do you get Exalate, how do you configure your synchronization for it to sync information back and forth and send the ticket to the other side. So let's get to it. You first need to download the Exalate add-on in each of the apps that you're going to integrate. So you'll need to go to the Atlassian Marketplace on the Jira Cloud end, download it, and you'll need to do the same for the Jira server end. If you want to integrate any of these tools with a Jira data center, then you'll need to do the same on the Jira data center. And in case you want, you're curious in which platforms we support any Jira product that has the ticket entity with all its structure. So it could be Jira Service Desk, Jira Core, Jira Business. So any version of Jira, Exalate is fully supported for all the fields that those tickets have. So I already have Exalate downloaded and configured from the Atlassian Marketplace. I gave it permission to create and edit issues and tickets. And now I can create a connection between these two products. So I'm going to go to this, click on this button, and then you will need to click on Manage Apps. I already have it open, but this is how it's going to look. If you see here, I have my Exalate buttons. And if you click on Connections, that is where you will be able to create a connection. What you see here is three transactions. Each of these transactions is a connection that could be active or deactivated, but they could be active all at the same time. So I could have a connection between the red Jira to the blue Jira, and then another connection from red Jira with another product that's supported by Exalate, like ServiceNow, Salesforce, Zendesk. We have tons of products that we now support. So if you click on Initiate Connection, it's going to ask for the destination instance URL. That is just the Jira URL on the receiving end. You'll need to copy it and paste it here. Now this verifies that there is an Exalate node on the receiving end. That's what it's doing. I already have it, so it's gonna be, yeah, it's gonna move to this next step. And now we have three options. In this case, I'm going to focus on the visual mode and basic mode. I'm going to have, I'm going to make another video specifically for the scripted version. This is a version that's more advanced and you can do some tweaks to it. So if you want to check how to make advanced configurations of the integration, check that other video that I'll post in the comments here. So in this case, I'm gonna go first for the visual mode. The visual mode is an intuitive UI where you're able to synchronize the data by selecting from dropdowns. You don't need to manually script any configuration that you want. It's very easy to use. You don't need coding experience. So it's if you have always been like a business analyst and you have never coded before, this is the option for you. I am going to create add a name to this connection. So I'm going to call it Jira Server to Jira Cloud Demo. Now you will need admin permission on both ends. In this case, the visual mode, you have one place where you configure the synchronization for both ends. So this is usually okay when you have, when you want to integrate multiple departments within your organization. But if you want to integrate multiple companies, we don't usually recommend the visual mode, because many times info security teams don't want one of the sites to control the entire data. So that is when we would recommend you to go for the scripted version that has a distributed architecture where each of the sites of the integration control their part. I'll elaborate more on that other video of the scripted connection. For now, I'm going to click on initiate. I already had confirmed this before, so Exalate already knows that I am an admin on both sites, so it allows me to continue with the visual mode. Now I already have a connection and I can start configuring this integration. And this is the first window that you will have. This is what we call the scope window. If you see, we have on the left the Jira server side and on the right the Jira cloud side. Now we need to select which project from Jira server is going to connect to which project on the Jira cloud side. So I am going to click on this arrow and select the initial project I want to start the synchronization from. It's going to be the test project, and I am going to connect it to post a test. Okay, let's look it up manually. There we go. So we are going to connect the project test from Jira server to the project hosted test in Jira Cloud. If I keep it as it is, I will only be able to sync manually, which means I will need to go to each of the tickets that I want to sync and click on a button to for it to go to the other side. This is not the most intuitive way. It's better to choose the manual, the automatic option, is if this is something that you want to happen automatically based on a trigger or an event. That's what most of our users go for, and most probably it's going to be your case too. So if I change from manual to automatic on the sync method, it means that any issue that I create on the test project in Jira server, could be a task, could be an epic, could be a subtask, whatever I create here is going to be automatically sent to the project hosted test. If I don't change this to automatic, then it's only going to be in one direction. But if I change the other, this second button to automatic, it's going to be any issue that I create from hosted test, it's also going to be sent to the test project. If you want only certain issues to be created on the other side, you can filter that by clicking on the filter option. And here you can filter a bit of which tickets you want to send to the other side. So maybe you only want to send tasks. If that's the case, you can click on this task value on the issue type. And if I click save, I will only be sending tasks from red Jira to blue Jira. If I create any other issue type, that will not be sent to hosted test. I'm going to do that. So if I create a task, that should be sent to Jira Cloud. You can do that the other way around too by clicking filter entities on the other side. I am going to click next. And now this is the second window, also very important. This is where you control which data will go back and forth. So the previous tab was to create the issue on the other side. This tab is to control what data will go back and forth after that issue is on both ends. So if you see the first row, labels will be synced with labels. So if I add a label to a ticket that is in sync, that label will show up on the other side too. If you don't want that to show up on the other side, then you will need to remove that mapping. And you will need to do the same with any other field that you don't want to sync. For example, I have the priority field here and I don't want to sync that field. So if I don't want to do that, I can just click here and delete the mapping. If you have different values in the dropdowns that you have from one side to the other, let's say the statuses are different, you can open this mapping, click on edit mapping, and map each of the statuses to the statuses on the other side. So maybe in one side I have to do in progress and done, but maybe on the other side you have open, getting worked on, and resolved. You can map them these three values to these other three values so that there's always a corresponding value when you do a change. And it will be automatically changed when that's updated on one of the sides. As you see here, we have the same mapping, so I'm going to keep it as it is. And I'm going to save this. By the way, the only difference between the visual mode and the basic mode is that it'll have a similar UI, but you have limited capabilities. So instead of having all these fields that you can synchronize, you can only synchronize title, description, comments, and attachments. So those will be the only four fields that you can synchronize. And they will always need to go bidirectional. There's no control over which direction you can go to or if I can do a mapping. Mappings are not possible. You can also only synchronize up to 1,000 updates per month on the basic mode. With the visual mode, you can synchronize as much updates, as many updates as you want. There's no limitation there. You can also synchronize custom fields, not only the fields that come with Jira. If you want to synchronize a custom field, you can just click here, add mapping, and select a field that's in your Jira server and select the field where you want to land on the Jira cloud side. Could be any field you want. For now, I'm going to keep it as it is. I'm going to publish this, and I am going to start synchronizing. Let's go back to Jira after this has been published and create a task so that we automatically send it to Jira. If any questions come up from this video, please feel free to make those comments in the comment section. And if this is useful, please like it. We will make sure to answer those comments with any question that could come up from this video. So we already published this configuration, and now we can go to the Jira project again and create a new task. So let's do that. I'm creating a task and I am going to call it this is a task from Red Jira. I am going to add the description. This is a description test, and I am going to create this ticket. Let's open it. Now let's see if we find it on the Jira Cloud side, if we refresh this project. Oh, we already have it here. So if you see my Jira Cloud side, we already have the ticket on Jira Cloud. And as you see, we have the title. This is a task from Red Jira, parenthesis server, and the description test. Just like we added the information on the Red Jira ticket. Now, if I make a comment from any of the two ends, that's going to show up on the other side because it's part of the fields that I added to the configuration. So I'll make a comment from Blue Jira. I am going to also add a label. I'm going to call it Exalate. And there we go. The comment. Now we have the comment here, and the label will show up soon. So this is the basic, some of the basic things that you can synchronize with Exalate. Again, if any question came up, please drop them in the comments. If you think someone else could benefit from this video, feel free to share it and like the video. I'm going to make more videos like this to connect Jira with other tools like Azure DevOps, ServiceNow, some other connection types like the scripted version that's coming soon for more robust scenarios. So I hope you enjoyed this video and see you soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye.